don't know the power of the dark side.
Hey everybody, it's Silver Bullet. Some people I don't know, my Counter-Strike name, Gary Valentine. This is my Halloween costume. This is, I thought it was too expensive to go out and buy the ultimate version, so I made it. So I'm just going to go over a few things here. This here is the helmet used. Go ahead and pan to the helmet there. This is the helmet used in the toy that came with this right here, the box. This used to have buttons across here to make different sounds, and there was a microphone inside here so that way I could talk into here. Well, I gutted this thing out, and as you can see, I put lights in there and did all the circuitry, nice and pretty looking. I even did a little bit of a paint job on there. Those are a couple of things that were store-bought. The other thing that was store-bought were the gloves. Bought the gloves because they looked good enough to use. I might make a pair, that way they match a little bit better because they are a bit of lighter black color than this. You can't really tell that much. Then this, the shoulder pads, is made out of camping foam that was carved out into this form. And then I went over with fiberglass resin along the outside of it. Kept the foamness on the inside, just painted it black so that way it was dark. The pauldrons do stretch out, not much, but they stretch out. And this part right here, this black stripe, covers up the edge, just like it does in the movie. And the same thing on this side. My cape, wool on the outside, satin on the inside, and I've got the trim, satin trim, on both the bottom and on the top, as well as the black chain to the hook, where the chain hooks onto. I also did, when I did the trim on the edges here, I had it inside out and I sewed it together on both edges and I put it right side out and then sewed about a quarter inch along the edge so that way this part wasn't flopping around like that, because that's what it was doing before, so I did that. So that's the outer cape. Then the inner cape is pretty much like a robe almost. It's just a very long shirt that goes down a little bit past the knees. And it has an opening in the front. Then I've got my belt, which is just a regular leather belt that connects in the back. And then my makeshift belt buckle. And then I've got my boxes here. They're kind of shoddy looking, but I was kind of running low on time. I am going to remake these for next year. These do turn on. They take 2 9-volt batteries, 2 white LED lights with the green boxes covering them up to make them green, and then a 9-volt red dome light put in there. Then, of course, I got my lightsaber, which is supposed to be a quick release, but I'm still having trouble learning it. This was one of those FX replicas, but I broke it several years ago, so I just cut the blade off. And then my hook was just a clip off of a tape measure, because I could not find a clip anywhere, Menards, Home Depot, nothing. So I said, screw it, I'll just buy a cheap tape measure and I'll take the clip off and use that. So then I just hooked the lightsaber back onto the clip there. It's kind of difficult, I'm still learning it. But anyways, then I got my cod piece, thing to protect my nuts from a lightsaber attack. That also has a belt that goes around and clips in the back. Then I've got the leather armor. What I did is it's actually pleather with a kind of weird fabric on the inside. I don't know if you can get a shot of that or not. Yeah, it's really, really itchy, so I strongly suggest that you wear something underneath. Like me, I'm wearing a turtleneck underneath it. That way it covers up my neck, too. Also, I do wear a mask to protect my hair. I just didn't put it on for this take, and I need to modify it anyways because it's 2 layers, and I'm going to cut one of the layers out and hem it up because it's too thick. The top of the helmet keeps popping off. So I'm gonna fix that. Then I've got my pants. If you guys seen the pictures, make sure you if you haven't, take a look at them. Got the leather pants there, and it has a back pocket right on my ass right there, so that way I can hold my wallet. Then I've got my shin guards. Did my best there to make them as accurate as possible, right down to the little swoosh right here that they have on the edges. And the bolts that hold them onto his leg. They're technically supposed to be bolted onto his leg. And then the other store-bought thing are boots. A lot of people are asking, why in the hell did you spend that much money on boots? Well, these things are fleece-lined on the inside, and on October 31st, it's always cold outside, and I'm not going to wear paper-thin pleather boots that are going to freeze my toes off. So I spent $120 on, yes, they're women's English riding dress-style boots. But what sold me was that. The design right along here. It looks very accurate to Darth Vader's boots. That's what sold me on them. So, that's my Darth Vader costume. Don't laugh at me. I'll kill you.